In this Lightroom video, we're going to look at five things that you're going to want to do to most, if not every single image that you edit. So these are the kind of everyday edits that will form the backbone of your image editing workflow. Now we'll start off here in Lightroom's Develop module in the Basic panel. And one of the first edits we want to make to most, if not every image we shoot, is to set white and black points. Now, our white point sets the point at which images go completely white, and the black point sets the point at which they go completely black. So typically, we want an image that displays a wide range of tones without being clipped at either the shadows or the highlights to complete white or complete black. So we can do this by dragging the whites to a point just before those pixels begin to clip. Now, if we hold Alt and drag the slider here, then this gives us a view that shows clipped pixels as we drag. So if I drag the whites across, eventually we'll start to see areas appear as clipped. And if I release now, you can see now our image is lacking detail in those highlights, so they're completely blown out. So we want to drag our whites to a point just before those pixels begin to clip. So somewhere around about there. I'm not too worried about clipping in the sun here because that's going to be lacking in detail anyway. So I'll drag it to around about there. And similarly with the blacks, we can drag that to a point where we start to see those clipped blacks appear. See, now the further we drag, you can see now we've lost detail in those shadow areas. So we want to drag it to a point just before those pixels begin to clip, or we can clip a few blacks. In general, if we clip a few blacks, it gives us nice deep shadows here, but we don't really want to clip any of our highlights. So now we know our image displays a full range of tones from black to white without displaying any unwanted clipping. And a useful keyboard shortcut here, if we want to do this quickly, if I just reset both of those sliders there by double clicking them, instead we can just hold shift and double click on the slider and Lightroom will automatically set it to the auto settings. So Lightroom automatically finds the point at which pixels begin to clip. So again, with the blacks, we can hold shift and double click the slider to set the blacks. And similarly, we can double click these other sliders here in the basic panel. So we could double click the highlights while holding shift and double click the shadows while holding shift, and that will set those sliders to the auto value as well. So we can set individual sliders to auto values by holding shift and double clicking them. So that's our first edit. Now let's move on to the lens correction panel here. Now in the lens correction panel, we have a couple of really simple settings here. Remove chromatic aberration here. Now this will correct any color fringing, and you'll often see color fringing in areas of high contrast where dark edges meet light edges. You might see a red fringe or a yellow fringe around those edges, and typically it occurs in wide angle lenses, especially around the edges of the image. So by checking remove chromatic aberration, we can just correct for any of that unwanted color fringing. We can also check enable profile correction here, and this will apply an automatic lens profile correction. So you can see the lens is automatically detected down here in these settings, or you can go in and choose a lens manually if you need to. So you can see these settings only take a moment to enable, and it's worth applying them to every image that you shoot, especially landscape images where they're really going to help to improve the quality of the image. Now, the third thing we're going to want to do to most, if not every image we edit, is to enhance the tones. And this, of course, involves lots of different tools and settings here in Lightroom. So the technique for this is going to vary depending on your image. But here I'd like to boost the sky. So what I'm going to do is up the vibrance to try and make the colors in the sky a little bit more intense. And also I'm going to apply a local adjustment to that sky. So I can go to my mask panel here by clicking this icon in the toolbar, and I'm going to go for select sky, and Lightroom will automatically detect that sky for me and add a mask to isolate it. Then I'm just going to drag the temperature to the left slightly to make the blue slightly more intense in the sky, and also just drag the exposure down a touch. That's a bit too far, somewhere around about there I think is going to be about right. And if I toggle that adjustment off and on, you can see that just helps to make the sky a bit stronger and more intense. The fourth thing we're going to do here is check for sensor marks. Now, if we grab the spot removal tool from the toolbar over here, and this allows us to quickly remove sensor marks, we want to have it set to heal up here in the options with opacity at 100%. Feather somewhere around about 50 is fine. And we can use the left and right square bracket keys on our keyboard to resize our brush tip. Now, if we zoom in a little closer here using Command or Control and Plus to zoom in, or Command or Control and Minus to zoom out, that's Command on a Mac, Control on Windows, and we can use Plus or Minus to zoom in or out, and we can hold space and drag to move around. So we can check for sensor marks around our image here. Now, if we're struggling to see any, we can always use Visualize Spots down here, and this will give us a handy view that shows sensor marks. So I can see there's a little sensor mark here in the sky, so I can click over that with the spot removal tool to get rid of it, and a couple of others around here as well. And then we'll have a quick check around the rest of the image, and I think that's looking fine, so we'll zoom back out. And then we can uncheck Visualize Spots. So it's worth checking for those sensor marks, especially when you're shooting landscapes, because typically you'll be using narrower apertures like the f16 aperture used to shoot this. And at those narrower apertures, those sensor marks are more likely to appear. And finally, the last edit we'll make here is to apply some sharpening. We can do that in the detail panel. And if we again zoom in to our image here, we can apply some sharpening. Let's just turn off our spot removal tool. And in the detail panel here, we can add sharpening and noise reduction. These are sort of two sides of the same coin, because we want to apply a decent level of sharpening, but the more we sharpen, the more we might see noise appearing in our image. So we want to drag our sharpening amount to a point where we crisp up the details. Now, the radius controls the distance from edges in the image in which that sharpening occurs. So typically with landscapes, we want to keep our radius fairly low, somewhere around about one or less. 0.9 works for us here. Then we can control the overall amount here to control the strength of the sharpening. If we hold Alt and drag the masking slider here, this gives us a view that allows us to restrict the sharpening to those white areas. So if I drag further, I know I'm not going to be sharpening those details in the background. There's really no need to, because all I'd really be doing is amplifying the image noise in those areas. And we can also apply a touch of noise reduction here using the luminance slider here. Luminance tackles that sort of grainy noise, whereas color targets the color noise in the image. So I can drag luminance up very slightly just to get rid of any grainy noise in our image. And that's looking really good. So there we go. That's five things that you're going to want to do to most, if not every, image you edit in Lightroom.